1971, Joni Mitchell released an album titled Blue, and it was an album that had many people in the music industry nervous. Because with this album, Joni Mitchell would do something no other artist had done up to this point. She wrote an entire album exploring her depression. And this was a big deal at the time, because being this open about your mental health wasn't the norm in 1971, and it wasn't something the music industry, particularly its boys club, was on board with. But Joni knew the value in being real and authentic in her work. The album peaked at number 15 in the US charts and would later go on to be called the third greatest album of all time by Rolling Stone magazine. Songs from the album would be covered by everyone from Prince to Sam Smith to CeeLo Green. Yeah, CeeLo Green covered it. While Joni may not have set out to write about mental health as we know it today, she knew she wanted to create something personal. Her emotional transparency on Blue would change music and pave the way for hundreds of artists over the next 50 years. So why did Joni risk her career to put out something so personal? And why do so many people still relate to what she was singing about today?
Hey, Blue, there is a song for you too.
While at a first listen it may have seemed like she was merely lamenting the breakdown of her romantic relationships, it would later be apparent that Joni was writing about deep depression. And while it's unclear whether her sadness stemmed from a chemical imbalance or her experiences or both, there's no doubt that after a series of events in her life, Joni Mitchell fell into a deep state of depression she could not come out the other end of.
Music is when you pull the chords from your inner core, whether they sound weird to people or not. My life was full at any time of 5 or 6 unresolved problems. So my harmonic movement was depicting my emotional situation.
Today, the World Health Organization actually classifies depression as the number one leading cause of disability in the world.
Please, everybody, give the warmest welcome to Miss Joni Mitchell.
And over the years, Joni has referred to her mental health as a sort of artistic torment, the great fight between wanting to heal your pain and worrying that fixing yourself will lead to becoming less of an artist, to losing your magic. And Blue is certainly magic. Though the process of making the album and the public reaction to it would almost break Joni entirely.
You know, maybe I'm kind of weird, but you know, when I'm sitting up here and playing and I hear all those people growling out there and stuff, it really puts me up tight and I forget the words and then I get nervous and it's really a drag. So, you know, I don't know what to say. Just give me a little help, will you? So that I can...
The songs on the album each hold a specific darkness within their often light melodies. Take the song California, for example. When she began writing the album, Joni had recently left California to travel aimlessly around Europe. And while this may seem like a privilege Joni worked really hard to achieve, she felt lost and lonely the entire time. The more time she spent away, the more she realized she couldn't escape her depression. And while all she had to do was get on a plane to go home, she didn't. She stayed and kept writing. This trip also led to her composing music on a 3-string dulcimer, as it was easier to travel with than a guitar. Because of this, she was able to compose a really unique sound for much of the album. In this song in particular, she pairs an exciting, seemingly upbeat melody with deeply sad lyrics. There were plenty of events that led up to the sadness Joni wrote about on Blue, not all of them public at the time of its release. One of the most significant may have been giving her daughter up for adoption in 1965, after becoming pregnant as a 20-year-old art student in Calgary, Canada, with no means to raise a child. Unable to tell her parents, and with the baby's father also not in a position to care for her, Joni went through this process on her own. And again, she found an outlet in her songwriting, penning Little Green about her child.
Born with the moon in Cancer,
name she will answer to. Call her green, and the winters cannot fade her. Call her green for the children who've made her little green. Be a gypsy dancer.
Then there are the romantic relationships, the relationship breakdowns that are said to have inspired many of Joni's songs. These weren't little slights either. These relationships broke down heavily and drastically affected her well-being. All I Want sees Joni reimagining a relationship as perfect when it very much wasn't.
I am on a lonely road and I am traveling, 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 looking for something.
My Old Man was written about being in seemingly domestic bliss while simultaneously experiencing a deep loneliness.
But when he's gone, me and them lonesome blues collide. You know the bed's too big, the frying pan's too wide.
In fact, Joni has said she felt so vulnerable and naked in her work while writing Blue that if anyone looked at her, she would burst into tears. Her male counterparts in the industry didn't help matters, with Kris Kristofferson and Johnny Cash among those who Joni has said were horrified by her honest and intimate lyrics at the time. She said Kristofferson told her to, quote, save something of yourself. Other musicians at the time told her that nobody would ever cover her songs, for they were too personal. We all know how that turned out. While many of today's most successful pop albums revolve around relationships, breakups, and the feelings of sadness they stir up, from Taylor Swift's Red to Olivia Rodrigo's Sour, these albums weren't a thing when Blue was released. One song, sure, but an entire album? These weren't breakup songs Joni was working through. These were explorations of mental health.
Miss Joni Mitchell.
After writing the album, Joni moved back to Canada and immersed herself in psychology books, trying to cure her depression, while fearing that if her sadness was gone, she would no longer be able to create in the ways that she had been. But she did. After Blue came 15 more studio albums, an overdue 1997 induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and a changing musical landscape that would see her cited as many artists' inspirations because of her honest pursuit of emotion. Fifty years on, it seems that we as a society are finally catching up to talking about things like depression and mental health. And while there's still plenty more to be done, there's no doubt that Joni Mitchell and her music had an impact. She connected with people. There's something powerful when you can listen to a song and just feel like someone else out there understands you. And for a lot of people, it just helps.